watching the Culver City Beat. I'm Juliette Lamar, and this week, a suspect is arrested for carjacking and elder abuse. He's in custody, and LA street food vendors are getting some financial relief in the wake of COVID-19. So stay tuned. But first, I want to tell you all about our sponsor, DBR Roofing. They handle any and all roofing work for your residential or commercial property. Our top story today, the last Wednesday in September is a celebration each year. It marks National Women's Health and Fitness Day. In today's video, we have a few COVID-safe outdoor festivities and activities to get your body moving. We'll be right back with the news after this story. Yes, yes, that was me out there on my rollerblades doing handstands in the park and all that. And now that it's so hot outside, I might just jump in the water and try surfing. Getting outside even a little bit in this time can change your whole day. Let us know how you celebrate National Women's Health and Fitness Day by sharing your videos and photos at our Instagram and Facebook accounts and by using the hashtag Women's Health Fitness Day. Now for what is happening in your neighborhood. A suspect has been arrested for an alleged carjacking and elder abuse on an 82-year-old Culver City man. The attack happened around 4:30 p.m. on August 31st at the 7-Eleven on Sepulveda Boulevard. The suspect assaulted the victim and forcibly removed him from his car. The 82-year-old man suffered serious injuries to his head and was hospitalized for over a week. He has since been discharged and is recovering at home. Follow-up investigations, forensic evidence, and video surveillance identified the suspect, Rosas, a man in his 20s, and Culver City police were able to make the arrest on Tuesday. That's all the information we have, but we'll keep you posted. A little market news for you today concerning street food vendors. Los Angeles City Council has voted to help LA street food vendors with $6 million in relief funding. It's called the COVID-19 Street Vending Recovery Fund, and it will be in the form of grants from the Federal CARES Act. According to CBS LA, vendors who apply for grants up to $5,000 will be able to use the money to pay for protective gear, permit applications, and special supplies to assist with legal operation of their carts and to adhere to current COVID-19 safety regulations. LA is home to around 50,000 street vendors with approximately 10,000 vendors selling food items. That's all the news we have for you today. Thank you all so much for tuning in. I'm Juliette Lamar, and you take care.